Hey, you guys, it's your girl, it's old school, coming back at you guys with another
another video, you guys. This is another video about your girl life. This is my story time, so sit back, relax, and enjoy my story time. And I hope somewhere along the way my story time will be able to help you. Let's get started.
Hey, you guys, so I had to take a break for a moment to change the shirt so I could get cool and feel comfortable. So, okay, now that I'm comfortable, I can go ahead with my story time. So, I moved from Norfolk. I moved from Norfolk to the state of Tennessee because me and my husband had got a divorce. Just kind of going back over things a little bit for those of you who are... This is your first time actually checking in to my channel. If you go back and listen to the rest of the videos, then you will get a clear understanding. But I'm just going to go over a little bit of it with you guys. So I left from the state of Virginia to come move to the state of Tennessee because I was married. And
my husband, he left me and he got married to another woman. So I felt like that I couldn't deal with that staying in the same city as this guy. I could not do that. So I was very stressed and, you know, felt down and anxiety and whatever else you probably want to call it. Your girl was going through. So I said to myself, I just cannot live here any longer. I have to get away from this place. So I went down to Tennessee and I found an apartment really, really quick. I found an apartment and I came back to Virginia, and I got my children, which was two kids that I had by then. I got my two children, and I got a U-Haul, and I got someone to drive it for me, and I came to the state of Tennessee. After I crossed the border of Virginia and Tennessee, because it's like Bristol, Virginia, and then next to it, you have Bristol, Tennessee. So after I crossed that borderline into Tennessee, I got outside of the U-Haul.
And I blew a kiss, meaning I'm finished, that's it, this is over, I'm going to start a new life without thinking about what this man did to me.
So that's what I was thinking in my head. So I blew a kiss, that mean it was over. So I got back in the U-Haul van and I never cried anymore. Remind you, I used to cry every day behind what had taken place with me and my husband, which was a Nigerian. So I cried every day. But once I got in that U-Haul and I crossed that border and I kissed the kiss, that was it. I never cried anymore behind this man. I never even thought of him anymore. So I went on to Tennessee and I had an apartment there that I went and got apartment. And I had like three bedrooms, got apartment. I had saved enough money to take care of that rent for, I guess, about 3 months. I had saved up enough to take care of the rent. So when I got there, my kids was very young when I moved there. I wasn't afraid at all. A lot of people say you wasn't afraid to get up and you know, take your kids and go to another state, not knowing anything about the state. Well, I did have a sister that lived in that state, one sister, but most of my family is all from the state that I came from. But I have one sister that was in Tennessee as well. So I got up and I came to Tennessee with my kids, and I got up every day and I caught the bus with my kids, and we rode around just looking at different places, and I had my pad and I was just writing down different signs. And I even told the bus man, I told him that I was new in town, and he told me to sit up the front of the bus. He say, so while you riding, I can kind of tell you what's what. So when I was riding, he was telling me that this is that building, this is that building, this is that building. So I was writing down the name of the bus that I was on and the number of the bus. And I was writing down different little places that he was telling me. This is human service. This is where you get your children birth certificate from. This is this place where if you want to get a job, they hire there. So he was telling me all those things like that. So I even wrote down his bus number that I was on and everything. Like I just said, I may repeat myself because I'm having like an anxiety right now. But anyway, so yeah, so I began to write down everything that he would tell me. And then the next day, I would catch another bus and I would tell the bus man. It was very nice to me. So I would tell him I'm new in town and I'm just trying to find my way around. And I rode the bus like all day long. And I even fixed my children lunch. And they got on the bus and I fixed their little sandwiches and their little drinks and everything. So we rode all day long and I was writing down different things, different signs and everything that I would see. And the bus driver, he would tell me also, this is this, that's that. And I would write down the things. And then I looked in the newspaper and I was looking for hotels. And I saw this very nice hotel called Vanderbilt. And that was a well-known area here in Tennessee. So I wrote down the name of that building and I called and asked them where they're hiring and they was like, yeah, we only have housekeeping available. And I was thinking to myself,
I don't want to do housekeeping. I have more experience than just housekeeping. I'm not doing no housekeeping. That's what I was thinking to myself. I'm not doing no housekeeping. I'm not cleaning no hotel room. But then I thought to myself, you just moved down here to another state. You can't be choosy. You need a job. You only have enough money to carry you through for 3 months, so you need a job. So I went on and took that job at that hotel.
And they trained me how to clean the hotel. So I went on and did it, and I stayed at that hotel for exactly about 7.5 years. I bought my car up there. I had a car in Virginia, but I think I gave it away or I sold it. I think I sold that car before I left to come to Tennessee. And so I bought another car in about 3 months. I bought another used car to get back and forth to work, which where I worked at wasn't too far from my home. So I made sure that I got a job that wasn't too far from my home. So I put the children in school and everything. So while they was at school all day long, I was working and I got off. I think I had to go to work at 8 o'clock to 4 o'clock was the time that I checked in. But anyway, yada, 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 make this count so I don't want this video to be too long. So I started working and I was able to pay all of my bills. I was able to take care of my car. I bought a little small car and I had a car note for like $200 a month. I was able to take care of the car note as well. And I was still on the weekends. I would still take the kids and we would walk on the weekends to look and see what was in our area so we would know where we was. So we would see where the Family Dollar is, the Dollar General. We would see where Burger King and everything was, which was not too far from our house. Anyway, so I did that. So I worked there 7 years and I did not really have a male companion then. I just really was focusing on me. So then I transferred from that job and went and worked for the state. And when I went to work for the state, I worked in the mail room at the state. So I wanted to tell you about this. I wanted to tell you about this other guy that I met when I was working for the state. He came in as a mailman and he had his uniform and everything on. And he said, to me, how you doing? I'm like, I'm good. How you doing? And he was like, you looking good. And I was like,
thank you. He came back the next day to deliver mail. So he said, do you have a telephone number? And I'm like, yeah, I have a number. What about you? And he was like, yeah, I have a number. So he gave me his telephone number and everything. I never asked him, was he married? I didn't ask him, was he married? I didn't ask him, did he have a girlfriend or anything? I didn't, so he called me on the phone. So he would call and he'd talk to me on the telephone. And, when I would go back to work next day, I would see the same mailman come in. And we just started talking a lot on the telephone. And
he never really, asked to take me out. So I was kind of, wondering why. But I didn't want to rush the issue of, you know, like bringing it to his attention. You never asked me out or anything, but we would talk on the phone a whole lot. And so then eventually he asked me, well, eventually I asked him, I say, well, you know, because we had talked on the phone probably about 3 months of just talking, you know. So I was like, I'm not going to rush it, you know. I'm still, like, you know, ready to, like, get my life started, but yet not being in a rush to get it started either. So he kept talking to me. So one day I did ask him, I said, when are we going to go out? Because I'm thinking, like, something's up with this. He's just talking to me on the phone. He's not asking me to go out at all, you know. So then one day he told me, and I just could not believe it. I was, like, overwhelmed. I could not believe it. I was getting myself involved with this guy. I was talking to him. I was really feeling him. I was liking him. He had a male uniform on, and I'm saying to myself, this man got a good job right here. This would be really good for me because I'm working with the state. He got a good job. He's a mailman, but he would always have this other man walking with him whenever he was delivering his mail. And I'm like, why is this other mailman with him and right up on top of him like this? I just couldn't understand why that was going on. So anyway, after asking him when was we gonna go out, then he told me, he said, well, you know what, I have something to tell you. So I was like, oh my God, here we go, here we go, here we go, another lying man, here we go. So I said, you know, what is it? And he said, well, let's talk tomorrow, because I got to get ready to go right now. And I'm like, something's not right with him. You know, he talked to me for hours, but now he got to get ready to go now. He told me he had something to talk to me about. So anyway, the next day he called me. And when I got off of work, I saw him. He came to the job like usual to drop off the mail. And he said, so we're going to talk tonight. So I said, okay, okay. So he gave me a hug. And I was like, you know, feeling all good. And you know, I'm feeling all good. I'm like, I kind of waited for some years before, you know, I got involved with someone. So I'm thinking this is going to be the one right here. You know, so anyway, he called me that night and he said, you know what, I got something to tell you. And I'm like, what is it? You know, and he was like, I said, are you married? He said, oh, no, I'm not married. So I said, you got a girlfriend? No, I don't have a girlfriend. So I'm like, okay, what is it? So he said, well, I want to tell you that I don't live alone. And I said, well, okay, well, who do you stay with? He said, I'm in prison. And I'm like, you in prison? For real? You in prison? So I'm saying to myself, oh my gosh, I done met a prison guy? You got to be kidding. I said, you in prison? I said, so how do you have a cell phone? I mean, how do you wear a real mailman uniform? Are you kidding? No, I'm not kidding. He said, I wouldn't lie to you. I'm in prison. I've been in prison for about 4 years now. And I have like 3 years to go. And, you know, I was like, so like, oh my gosh. So he said, well, you know, if that'll be a problem, I understand. I know I should have told you from the get-go, but I didn't tell you. So if you don't want to talk to me no more, I do understand. And if you don't want to talk to me no more. So by then, I had then already got my feelings and everything kind of like, you know, into him thinking, you know, it's going to really go somewhere. You know, this guy's really nice. He didn't push me about going out with him. He didn't push me about none of this. And then not thinking to myself, why didn't he kind of push me? Why haven't he asked me like to go out? I did think about it, but like not really thinking about it. So anyway, I was just, oh my goodness, I just could not believe that he told me he was in prison. So anyway, you guys, I said, okay, we're going to talk again. Can I go? I need to go. I need to relax my mind. I need to think things over. Can you call me back tomorrow? We'll talk again, but I need to go right now. I need to go. So you guys, hey, I have more to tell you about this situation with this new guy in my life.
The mailman, can you believe it?
Wow, shocked.